Have you heard of covariant return types in C#? They were added to C# 9 to change how we see derived classes and classes implementing interfaces. Here is the story of covariant returns. Imagine you have a class with a virtual or abstract method that returns an object of some product type. The relationship to the product class is that the class on the left creates its instances. You can derive a class and override behavior. This derived class is still creating instances of that same product type as its base does. But that is not what we usually do. More often than not, a specific product type would also derive from the base product class, adding state or behavior. Look at this picture now. The derived class uses the base product but creates the derived product. Nothing would change if we had an interface that returns an abstract product. The derived class would still declare abstract results, but in fact return instances of the concrete derived product. This picture is far from ideal. Let me point out the issue. Everything above this line is abstract. Everything below it is concrete. There are two levels of abstractness in this picture. That would affect any consumers of this system of classes. One consumer might only know about the interfaces. Another consumer might know about abstract classes. Both of these consumers can only use abstract kinds of the product. Even though the actual product object would be of the most derived type, equipped with the additional method, that method is beyond reach to both abstract consumers. They simply don't know it exists. But another consumer might know more. It could come from a bundle of concrete classes, performing a narrow responsibility that depends on the derived product concrete class. Well, bummer! Now we have the opposite issue. Indeed, this class belongs to the same bundle and knows about all concrete classes. But the concrete derived class only returns abstract types. The specific operation on the derived product is once again beyond reach, with no rational explanation. That is the design flaw, and it has been a native part of C# from its inception. But now it's gone. C# 9 allows a derived type to declare a more specific return type so long as that type is assignable to the one declared in the base type. As you will see, implementing an interface this way will require special consideration, but the principle is straightforward on method overrides. We can return a derived product type from the override in the derived class. The declaration would compile fine. One would expect it to work the same with interfaces too, but that is not supported yet. I will show you a workaround in a minute. At the conceptual level, this interface might use another interface that any product type must implement. With a covariant return type in the ultimate implementation, the concrete consumer could access the specific members of the derived product as it always wanted to. Let me show you some code now. It will be interesting because of that workaround regarding interface implementation. I'll begin with the abstract layer, which consists of the product interface and the producer interface that returns it. A bundle of abstract classes may combine interfaces with concrete implementations, retaining a certain level of abstraction. However, the ultimate implementation, and the only one whose objects we will ever use, will consist of concrete classes. This part of the model knows the most. It can employ specific optimizations and algorithms that do not apply to abstractions. Yet the class only returns abstract products, robbing its consumers of this hidden power. Enter C# 9 and covariant returns. If I change the return type to the concrete class this time, it would still compile. Observe the slightly confusing declaration of this method. It overrides the base method, but then it changes its return type. As I said, starting with C# 9, this is perfectly legal. I will try the same with the interface method, but it will not compile this time. The covariant return types feature of C# 9 is not final yet. It will be extended in the future to include interface methods too. As of now, we need a workaround, and I will show you two of them. The easy workaround is to implement the interface explicitly. That would give you access to the same method at the abstract and concrete levels, making everybody happy. Another option is to let the base class implement the interface and then just override its virtual method as before. Both possibilities are valid, and your choice should depend on whether the base class implements that interface. Of course, if the base class opted for a covariant return, we would be back at square one again, leaving the explicit interface implementation as the only option. I think this is acceptable. You don't have to dislike it. As I said, the consumer can use this class through the interface or the class reference, getting precisely what it asked for each time. I will now implement the consumers. There are three levels of consuming these types. At one level, we may only see the interfaces. One step down, we may have a glimpse of classes, but still too abstractly to access any of the low-level features that exist. The third and most potent variant operates at the level of concrete classes. It is up to you to decide at which level your consuming classes should operate. You would naturally pick the level that requires the fewest obligations, which means the most abstract level possible. That will also define the power of the methods you write. At the most abstract level, you will only have access to the most general members of the abstract types you possess. A bit more concrete, but still quite abstract, I can only operate in general terms. But if you need access to extended behavior, performance optimizations, or anything specific, there will be no other way than to get your hands dirty. Go and speak to concrete classes. This line was not only impossible with the abstract types, but it was also impossible with any classes before C# 9. Now it works, and I think you should start making calls like this one in your designs. That is the covariant return types feature of C# 9 at work. Now that you know it, start using it in object-oriented design.